By the Republicans for a second now, where New York is all but a lock for Donald Trump. But at a moment where every delegate counts, it's definitely going to be a race to the finish for Trump and Cruz. NBC's Katie Turr is here with that part of the story. Katie, good morning to you.
Good morning to you guys as well. Every delegate counts because Trump needs to avoid a contested convention where Cruz could take the nomination on a subsequent ballot. That's why Trump's team is reorganizing, beefing up his inner circle, and laser focusing on scoring a big win in New York State. Donald Trump continuing to decry the rules, but insisting he'll come out on top.
It's a disaster and not fair. So we're going to win it anyway. We're going to have our 1,237 anyway.
Trashing the system and trying to bury Ted Cruz, Trump echoing a now familiar chant before a rowdy crowd of supporters.
Lying Ted. He walks into a room with his Bible held high. Held high. It's lying Ted, folks. Puts down the Bible and then he lies.
The Trump team sharpening its game plan in the final primaries before the convention. New experienced advisors adding structure and talking points to the normally impulsive campaign.
Cruz talked about New York values. That was a bad thing. And he said it with hatred toward New Yorkers.
Sources close to the campaign telling NBC News the strategy going forward is to appeal to voters who feel left behind by Washington without turning off delegates, often party loyalists. Trump said to have a lock on New York, but after a tough 24 hours, Cruz drew a crowd of 1,200 in Rochester Friday night.
Tuesday is election day here in New York. And New York, the whole country is looking at New York right now. Amen, sir.
Not a lock, former Apprentice contestants, a number of whom gathered in New York to denounce their would-be boss.
We strongly condemn Donald's campaign of sexism, xenophobia, racism, violence, and hate.
Trump responding in typical fashion, calling the angry contestants wannabes. Guys, busy day in the campaign trail again today. Yeah. Trump with two rallies upstate.
Let's talk about the Dems here, because we had that raucous debate Thursday, and you mentioned it in your piece there. The optics here. Yeah. You've got Bernie Sanders meeting with the Pope, talking about social justice. Meanwhile, you've got Hillary Clinton on the West Coast hanging out with the Clooneys at a $350,000 couples dinner. Are they worried at all about the optics?
Well, the optics couldn't be tougher for the Clinton campaign this weekend. There's no doubt about that. That's why she scheduled that meeting with low-income seniors before she left for those big fundraisers. She's going to have a rally in California. This has been something that the Clinton campaign's been dealing with throughout this campaign, because she has to raise money the old-fashioned way. She has to go out to these high-dollar fundraisers. Bernie Sanders just gets in front of a microphone and says, hey, send money to my website. And that's essentially what happens. He rakes in millions of dollars, but it allows him to make this argument that he is, in fact, the candidate of the working class. And it really brings this into sharper focus, I think, this whole dichotomy this weekend. Will it hurt Secretary Clinton here in New York? The Clinton campaign doesn't think so. If you look at the polls, she's doing so well, it's doubtful. But are her potential Republican challengers taking notes? Yes, this is something that could come back to haunt her in
general. Well, that's the thing. You mentioned the poll. She's ahead by, what, 17 points? Yeah. But you look at these crowds with Bernie Sanders. They're still enthusiastic. Let's talk about this, though, for a moment. Bernie Sanders, does he have a realistic path, or is he a spoiler at this point?
Well, and that's the real question, right? The Sanders campaign argues, yes, they absolutely still have a realistic path. They look at May. They look at the states where they think they can do well there. Oregon, possibly West Virginia, some of those other May states. But the reality is, guys, and we've been saying this for a long time, in order for him to win, he has to start winning these bigger states, New York, Pennsylvania, New Jersey, Connecticut, and by big margins. And that's why a loss here is so devastating, because it's the first test that he might not be able to do that, and that becomes a lot tougher for him.
And he would also have to flip a number of superdelegates.
That's absolutely right.
So on the Republican side here, we've got, of course, some new polling, some reasonably new polling. This NBC4 Marist Wall Street Journal poll, it shows Donald Trump with a commanding lead, to say the least, here in New York State, 54, 25, 16. Ted Cruz far behind the pack there. He writes this op-ed in Wall Street Journal this week, complaining, among other things, about the delegate selection system, rules that have been in place for some time. Why pick this fight now? What's with the timing?
It's very important for the Trump campaign to appear like they are not on a losing track. And right now it's becoming more difficult to get to the magic number of delegates that they need, 1237. And by decrying the rules and saying this is not fair for them, they're able to galvanize their support and they're able to come off as still the winners despite the rules. But what is really interesting is that Wall Street Journal article yesterday, even though he was decrying the rules, he wasn't calling out the RNC. He wasn't calling out Reince Priebus. He said he would work with Reince Priebus. That's because he's changed the structure within his campaign to more experienced insiders who realize that he has to get along with the RNC. He has to not alienate party loyalists who are oftentimes delegates because he needs those delegates to get to the contested to the convention to avoid a contested convention. He does not want to see that. That does not benefit him. Ted Cruz is much better at organizing so far and could do very well on a second, third, fourth ballot.
Great conversation this morning. Great to have you guys here. Katie Turr, Kristen Welker, thank you.
Thank you.